Hi everyone, it's your boy Zach, and this freaking Conan movie is killing me. So on my other channel I do comic book reviews. There's a secret to knowing if someone is if a book is actually popular versus people just lying and saying it is, because the comic book companies and the shill media, they're always saying things that are abject failures, like books that don't even sell 1,000 copies. They'll say they're a hit, but I can always tell if something's popular or not when I go to get an image for the thumbnail and there's barely any, there's like barely any photos of that comic. So that's what's happened right now with the Conan the Barbarian from 2011 with Jason Momoa. So I just watched it, but here's another hint that it's not good and nobody likes it. It's only $1.99. Almost every other movie is $2.99 or $3.99. But I bought it on YouTube and it was only freaking $1.99. So I had to buy it a second time just to finish it because I ran out of time. But so this one is a little weird for me because I actually saw this before I saw the other ones all the way through. I had seen little bits and pieces of Conan the Barbarian, you know, growing up on cable. I was like fresh out of the army. I was going to animation school, so they were doing the big promotion, and I actually thought that the 2011 Conan looked pretty good. I remember it being a big flop, and I just double checked and it was. For some reason I thought that Conan the Destroyer was a flop and that's why they didn't make more of them, but both the Conan movies and Red Sonja all made a good profit. It was just scheduling. Arnold got super popular in the late 80s, early 90s, so he always kind of had bigger fish to fry. So I remember when I saw it on DVD, when it came out on DVD, and I remember thinking it was okay. Like, I didn't get why people hated it, but then something else interesting happened. While I was getting ready to review this, I started talking to all my friends who are, like, you know, sword and sorcery, specifically Conan fans, and people just didn't see it. Like, this movie was a super flop. It lost tens of millions of dollars, and it got memory hold pretty quickly, except for just people generally, if they did remember it, having a bad memory of it. So I just rewatched it right now, and this movie, one of the things I kept saying is, you know, at least for like the first three quarters, there's not a lot that is specifically awful. It's just this weird type of movie where it came about in 2011, and there's a couple of problems related to that. Number one, this is when TV shows like Battlestar Galactica started really doing like feature film quality stuff on TV. So the difference between a TV show and a movie had almost disappeared. And then this movie is basically shot like a higher budget TV show. There are a lot of flat angles. There are a lot of just like, okay, this is fine, but I could see this, you know, on cable on a dozen different shows. That's just weird. Okay, so one of the things that might sound very superficial and kind of dumb, but I don't think Jason Momoa was in good enough shape to play Conan, or Conan as they pronounce it. Obviously coming out of, you know, Arnold Schwarzenegger in the 80s, and there was even some TV show in the 90s with I think his name was Rolf Mueller or something like that. You're supposed to be like a bodybuilder type. Jason Momoa, and if you go back and you see it, you're going to be shocked at how small he is. He's a beast now, like in Aquaman, he's huge. But he's kind of like, I wouldn't call him doughy, but he kind of just looks like your coworker who like buys off-the-shelf creatine at like Walmart and he works out. Like, he's not that big. He's not ripped. He's not low body fat. So you're like, did you get cast and they started shooting like a week later? So the other thing about him is he's not mythic. He's not larger than life in size or his body shape, you know, the level of fitness or even just like personality. Now, a lot of people have pointed out that the Conan from Conan the Barbarian with Arnold and then the Conan the Destroyer they're fairly significant. You can almost call Conan the Destroyer a soft reboot. But they're both like mythic, larger than life. And then this is just like Jason Momoa in 2011 was basic cable Conan. It feels like a pilot episode. So the weirdest thing is, you know, they start off, it's done chronologically. They start with him as a kid. Well, first as a baby, as a kid, like, I don't know, 10 or 11, 12. And then they cut to him being an adult. And weirdly enough, usually I hate scenes like this. But the younger Conan scenes are actually better than the other ones. There's this one kind of like a training scene that turns into a battle scene with young Conan. And it's actually pretty cool. And I almost felt like they just should have done a really low budget. And that part is very, very like TV budget level. It's just, you know, I'm sure they shot in Croatia or something like that. It's just a village and there's a couple people with, you know, prop swords, but it's shot very well. And then when we get to, you know, the mainstream story, it actually starts off like okay, but again, it's like some BBC, you know, Robin Hood show. Like all of this stuff is very TV shot, TV budget. Nothing is terrible, but nothing is especially great. And then the movie progresses, or let's say devolves. Oh my gosh. At the end, I kept getting more, it gets worse and worse as it goes on. And finally, I kept racking my brains because I had to go back to this time frame, 2011. It's very much of that time frame. They don't really make movies like this anymore. Like it started with this really cheesy, over-the-top computer titles and graphics and prologue. And then, you know, the quick cuts. There actually is some fairly good like sword fighting and sword handling. I think that's the thing I thought Jason Momoa did the best. His sword handling and sword fighting skills were very good. But again, a lot of flat angles, just a lot of medium shots, a lot of close stuff. No, nothing mythic. And again, everything you like, you've seen somewhere else. Not better, but the same. That's almost what is even worse. It's like you could have, if you would have told me this was not directed by one person, it was directed by 12 different people who all, you know, work steadily in television, I would have said, yeah, that's what it feels like. You know how, you know, you, a season of a TV show, it'll have the, you know, the showrunner and the producers, and they'll decide the tone. And then there will be, you know, sometimes a different director for like every episode, but it all feels like the same because, you know, they're told like, this is how we do our shots. This is how we do our cinematography. This is how we do our color correction. This is, you know, the style of writing. So very, very bland. And then at the end, it turned out to something that is kind of, you know, its era has passed, but that I forget the name of that guy. The guy who did the Pirates of the Caribbean, Gore Verbinski. It turns into Gore Verbinski for like the last 30 minutes. And that part is excruciating. That's the thing where all the people who would have walked out and been like, man, it was pretty solid. That's the thing that turned the word of mouth to absolute trash. So they got this, you know, Stephen Lang. He's a, you know, a wannabe warlock. His daughter's a witch. There's this mask that has to be you know, activated by the pure blood of this, oh gosh. Oh, what is her name? Rachel Nichols. She was Scarlet in the G.I. Joe Rise of Cobra. And she's a good actress, but she's very, very modern. One of the things, and then they have to do this modern thing. So she's introduced, and it looks like she's some sort of like Vestal Virgin, you know, or like a what is that from 300? The women who see the future. So she's, you know, she's in this like kind of like a cult, but and she's talking to the leader and she's just kind of like giggling with girls. He's like, oh, I see a man. He's like, ooh, is he handsome? And they're all like giggling. So it's like but later they say that she's a monk there. It's like she didn't really seem like a monk. Then she's kind of a symbolic princess of an ancient bloodline. And then did you guess it? She's also super awesome at fighting, at least way more awesome than she looks. Because she just looks like a regular, you know, woman in her 20s. One of the great things about the, you know, original Conan movies is they gave people specialties. You know, obviously the wizard was a wizard. He's called, I think, Akiro in the second one. You have the guy who's, you know, the thief. You had warrior women who looked like warrior women. You had Valyria in the first one, and I forget what Grace Jones's character was in the second one. But like, they're fit, they're muscular, they're athletic. What's it? Agile. That's what I was gonna say. And they look like it. So when they're in fight scenes, you totally believe them. And this woman has like no muscle tone. She's dressed like a Disney princess, and it's just awful. So then at the end, like, she's on this circular thing and she's about to be sacrificed, except for they have like this stupidly overly complicated spell. It's like you need to drain her blood to activate the mask, and then this will help you do X, Y, and Z. But so I always imagined they were like gonna like slit her wrists or something like that, or her neck, and it was just gonna like pour all of this blood and it would activate the mask. But it's basically like a skateboard injury. It's like the amount of, you know what I mean? It's like you're working in the garage and you had a oopsie. It's a tiny amount of blood, because I forgot that then she's supposed to be possessed. And I was like, isn't her being killed worse than, like, because then the possession, so there's the witch, and then Conan fights her, and then, you know, Little Miss No Muscle Tone, a monk, a princess, and a warrior, she does the final kick. And then they knock the witch and she falls onto just like a post for a fence way down at the bottom of like this ridiculously huge underground structure. And then, oh, so I was talking about, she's tied to this thing. So it's above this bottomless pit. So you're like, all right, cool. That's dramatic. And then there's an earthquake, like a CGI earthquake. And then the thing falls, and it falls like 100 meters down, and then it lodges, but it's still above this great chasm. And then Conan jumps like 100 meters down and lands on it, which would have surely dislodged it. And then there's a fight on it. Then it starts flipping. I'm like, oh God, this is Pirates of the Caribbean. This is a Pirates of the Caribbean stunt CGI jokey. Ah, it's so freaking bad. So then, weirdly enough, after all this buildup over 2 hours, both the witch and the warlock are killed pretty darn easily. The witch is just has her hand cut off with a sword and then kicked off of a cliff and then is impaled on something. And it's even worse for the warlock. He's on this bridge. Oh, and they do that whole thing from like Lord of the Rings through all those like 2000 to like 2015. Oh, we're running on a bridge and it's collapsing below us, or, you know, a bunch of stuff is falling, but amazingly, as we run, it falls right. Like, it's not dramatic at all. In Conan the Destroyer, they go to, like, you know, this crystal palace, and it's crumbling, and they're, like, going away on this little float. And then they start, you know, they start break, the crystal palace starts breaking. And you can tell it's just styrofoam, and, you know, guys off screen are pushing it. But it actually looks cool, and it's kind of exciting and inventive. And this is just trash. Like, I hated it. I got really, really bothered and angry. So by the end, I was just like, just F off. Just, I'm done with you. So, and then I looked at the director and the screenwriters, and it looks like their, you know, careers just kind of petered out, or they went back to advertising and TV. And, that being said, I would like to see, Jason Momoa as King Conan. He's, you know, what is he, like 40 right now, early 40s. And he's actually in the right shape. Like, he's gigantic, he's like striated, and he's got a lot better at acting and like knowing his strengths and things like that. So even though I was mildly entertained and then grew to hate this movie, I actually would like to see King Conan with Jason Momoa. So anyway, don't go see this movie, please. It's, even at, I didn't feel ripped off at $1.99. Obviously, it's very, very cheap, but man, was this annoying. I'm trying to think of if I missed anything else. Oh, they have, you know, oh gosh, the writing. Oh my gosh. So at the beginning, which is pretty good, they get into this, like, Conan's dad is below a thing with molten steel and he has to hold the chain, but the chain is burning. So his dad tells him to let it go and he doesn't want to do it and he feels guilty. So then at the end, guess it. So they have the, you know, Rachel, the princess everything, and she's hanging from a chain, but she's getting possessed, so he should let her go. But he's all heartbroken, and then the villain is literally like, it ends as it began, with you holding a chain. Like, it's so, like, bad writing 101. And then you know how the bad guy gets killed? He's on a wooden bridge, and then Conan just puts his sword through the bridge, and then the part of the bridge with the warlock breaks, and then he falls to his doom, but the part that Conan's on is fine. Actually, it was like on a little stone support structure, but it's still, like, it was very underwhelming and very lazy. But tell me what you think about this movie. I couldn't find anyone who saw it. All my friends who, like, pattern their whole life over the, like, the Arnold movies, they're like, eh, I didn't see it. Just like a big zero. And it was like it wasn't even word of mouth killed it. Like, it was DOA. So anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll have another video up tomorrow.